Hey everyone, I'm Coach Samira with Love Advice TV, and today we have Coach Adrian standing with us.
Hello!
And today we're going to talk about signs that your ex does not want you back. So this is a really popular topic. I'm sure you get these in your coaching sessions.
Of course.
I definitely get them in mine. And it's really important to really look at those signs and see what are the signs that your ex does not want you back. You know, it's so easy to just be, you know, blind with love and not be able to see those signs, but you know, it's important to take a step back, focus on yourself, really work on that self-improvement, and you know, that will also help build confidence, so you'll be able to see the signs that are, you know, in front of you, right?
Absolutely right. And the truth of the matter is that after a breakup, you're in a negative bubble and you don't have perspective, you're biased, and oftentimes you see the glass half empty. Mm-hmm. And the sad thing is that the people around you, your friends and family, are also sucked into that bubble in some way, shape, or form because they're affected by your sadness. Mm-hmm. And they just want you to be better. So they'll tell you what they think you need to hear to quickly move on. And it comes from a place of love, but sometimes they misread the signs, just like you misread the signs. And so that's why I think that this video is super duper important, because we can give you honest, unbiased advice and perspective here. And the best, clearest sign that your ex does not want you back is when you've done the work. When you've taken your time, you've gone through the process of personal transformation, you have not been needy, you are happy again, you don't feel like you can exist without your ex, and you reestablish contact with them, they're happy, they also have managed to move forward, and they just aren't receptive to your approach. Those are clear signs that your ex does not want you back, because you've done the work and you've exhausted all possible options. The problem is that most of you have not done the work, and all of you probably have not exhausted all possible options. And so that, for me, is the best way, the most surest indicator that your ex does not want you back is precisely that. And from my experience, I know that you haven't gotten that to that point yet. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay, mm-hmm. Fantastic. So, yeah, because Coach Samira sees your questions in the comment section. Mm-hmm. She has had the opportunity to work with a lot of you in coaching sessions. And off the record, we often talk amongst each other about the stories and the mistakes that people have made, and most of you don't see the sign because you haven't gotten there yet in the process. Mm-hmm. So the signs that your ex want you back that you may perhaps are thinking about is when your ex does not reply to your phone calls, to your text messages, to
when
your outreach,
you.
When they ignore you, when they're mm-hmm. negative, when they say mean things. And sure, it means that your ex does not want you back for now. But it does not mean that they won't ever want you back if you approach this process the right way. Mm-hmm. So, Coach Samira, what is approaching the process the right way for you, in your opinion?
I think with a lot of the coaching sessions I've been seeing, you know, starting off with no contact is a really important thing to do. Because then you're taking that process and you're taking that time to focus on yourself and, you know, work on that self-improvement and do things that you like to do. And, you know, use this time that you have to really do things that you like. You know, sign up for a class, you know, cook something new from like a different culture or something. Yoga, journaling, exercise. There's so many different things you can do. And that's why it's called a process, too. When you're getting through the process of really figuring out your own stuff and really being able to, you know, improve yourself so that you can be in a healthy and happy relationship in the future.
Amazing. Well said. I couldn't agree more. And don't mistake your ex testing you with signs that your ex does not want you back. Again, remember, we're dealing with a breakup or a separation or a divorce. This isn't a fight or an argument. Mm-hmm. They're not going to react the way that they used to when you guys would argue. If they did, you wouldn't be on our channel, quite frankly. Because a lot of you wait until it's too late to reach out to us, and I understand. But it is a breakup, and they are going to be defensive. They're going to change. They're going to be negative. And that's normal. It's what we see day in and day out. And that is not a sign that your ex does not want you back. It's important for you to remember that, so that you don't get desperate, throw in the towel too quickly, or overreact and do even more mistakes, because I know that you see a lot of that happen.
All the time, yeah, because people can get really anxious and really, you know, a little bit impatient and want the process to, you know, happen now and everything to start now. And why can't I have this perfect and happy, great foundation right now? But, you know, the thing to keep in mind is that you have to work for it. It doesn't just happen out of thin air, you know? Just like the breakup, sometimes, most of the time, doesn't happen out of thin air. Because, you know, there are some things that are building up that leads to that. And, you know, that's just a process too. So comparing those things together, it's important that, you know, you work through your process and that, you know that you have to be patient with yourself and be kind to yourself and, you know, just tell yourself that it's okay if it's taking a little bit of time.
Absolutely right. So if you're watching this video, I'm sure that you learned something new. Mm-hmm. And you perhaps thought you had seen signs that your ex did not want you back and you've gained clarity. And if you have, share it in the comment section below. Explain what you've learned so that others can learn and gain that clarity as well.
Yeah.
And if you think that you still have seen signs that your ex does not want you back, perhaps something that we have not covered in this video because our time is limited too, put it down in the comment section below. And you know that Coach Shamira will be here to tell you if indeed this is a sign that your ex doesn't want you back, or if you're jumping the gun and you're being too negative and you're being sucked back into those negative bubbles that we talked about earlier on in this video. So, as always, thank you for giving us purpose. We love doing these videos for you and we get so much love back and we're so grateful and thankful. And perhaps we'll see you soon in a coaching session or in the comment section. Keep fighting the good fight, my friends, and see you soon.